into the mat. Arms are going to come to your side. Find your neutral spine. Inhale to lengthen the fingertips up. Exhale to round over the knees, lengthening through the crown. Articulate through the spine to come back to neutral. Inhaling. And exhale, round. Hollowing out the torso, lengthening through the crown of the head. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, drawing shoulder blades away from the ears. Exhale, rounding forward. Inhale. Lengthen on this exhale. Start to lengthen through the fingertips. Tuck the tailbone, lean back. 45 degrees, draw the shoulder blades away from the ears. Bringing the fingertips to the ears, lengthening overhead. Exhale to round forward. Articulating through neutral. Tucking the tailbone, lean back, arms extending to the front. Tuck those thumbs by the ears. Reaching overhead like you're taking off a top hat. Exhale to round forward. Focus on keeping your knees facing the ceiling and the heels grounded into the mat. You can relax the ankles. Inhale. Exhale, round forward. Articulate to neutral. One more. Tuck that tailbone. J curve. Lean back. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, round forward. On this inhale, we're going to come to neutral. J curve back. Extend the arms to the front. Drawing shoulder blades away from the ears. We're going to lengthen through one side at a time, bringing the leg up to a V. Tighten through the quad. Lower it down. Inhale. Exhale, switch sides. Lengthen. Belly button's drawing to the spine. Keeping energy through the crown. Tailbone is grounded. J curve through that lumbar vertebrae. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Good. Very little rock through the body. And exhale. Lengthen. And exhale. Two more. Then we're going to maintain a boat pose. Inhale. Draw those toes up to neutral. Lean back just a little bit. Hold your boat. Space between the knees. About an inch, inch and a half. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to release. Inhale, start to lengthen through the toes. Exhale, release. Sit up nice and tall. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, feel those quads. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale, let's make it a little harder. Inhale, open, close, return to bow. Inhale. Lengthen, open, close, return to bow. Two more. Inhale. Open, close, return. Inhale, open, close. Last one. Inhale and close. Good. Lowering the feet down, come up to neutral. Tuck that tailbone, roll down vertebrae by vertebrae. We're going to ground the heels. Hands are coming to your side. We're going to go to a bridge series. Pressing through the heels, tuck that tailbone, roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. We'll just keep it in neutral for now. So articulating down, inhale, exhale, tuck the tailbone, roll up nice and slow. Tuck the tailbone as you roll down, then release through that neutral. Decrease any compression through the lower spine. Lengthening through the fingertips. Slow control down. Exhale, lift. Squeeze the glutes, energy through the quads. Knees are spaced equally when you're at the bottom as you are when you're at the top. And we'll start to pulse it here. So coming down about halfway, exhale, pulse. Inhale, exhale, pulse. Press those shoulder blades into the mat. Maintain space between your shoulders and your ears. Decrease any compression into that cervical spine. And focus on those glutes. Inhale, drive through the heels. Exhale, we're still pulsing. Three more. Three, two, and one. Let's articulate back down. Reset the heels and turn them out. So we're in a wide semi-second position. We're going to work those outer thighs and roll down. Good. Let's keep that spine in neutral as we lift and lower. Squeeze and lower. Tuck that tailbone. Spine maintains neutral. articulating down anymore. Four more. Three. Two. Last one. As those hips come down, we'll reset back to more of a parallel position. We're gonna squeeze the glutes, come up to your bridge, but we're gonna lift one leg up at a time into a march. Slow, control down. You really have to fire that opposite glute to keep your hips from swiveling. March and down. Pull. March. Slow, control. Maintain hip placement. Protect the vertebrae. Keep your gaze up towards the ceiling. Energy through the fingertips. Two more. And return. Slow control down. We're gonna take it into a roll up. Extending through the feet, ground the heels. Lengthen through the fingertips, take an inhale. On the exhale, energy as you reach towards the ceiling, roll up vertebrae by vertebrae and round towards your toes. We're gonna add in a saw here. Articulate through neutral, take it out to a T, flex the feet, reach opposite hand, saw off that pinky toe, articulate back to your neutral, rotate and saw off that opposing pinky toe. Back to T, tuck that tailbone, slowly roll it down, vertebrae by vertebrae. Inhale, lengthen through those hip flexors, reach. Exhale, roll up, ribcage draws in, exhale. Up to a T, rotate, twist. Lengthen, rotate, twist. Keeping a lot of energy through the crown as you head, crown of your head as you reach towards your opposite toe. Exhale, rolling up. Keep that rib cage in. Rib cage to the hips. Sit up nice and tall. Rotate to your T. This is where you want to keep that space in your vertebrae as you reach. Twist. Feel that flexibility gain through the hamstrings. Keep the energy through the legs as you lower down. Inhale, lengthen overhead. Exhale, rolling up. Big reach. T. Rotate. Lengthen. Back to neutral. Rotate. Lengthen. And slowly lower down. Three more. Stretch. Out to T. Rotate. Twist. Feel those obliques. And roll down. Two more. Notice there's still space between your shoulders and your ears when you lie back down on the mat. And nice and slow descent. Last one. Bringing the legs up to tabletop, imprint the spine, tabletop the legs first, hands can be at your side. We're gonna reach those toes up towards the ceiling. Try to make them as perpendicular with your body as possible. Check your core in, belly button's drawing to the spine, rib cage is drawing down. Keeping those inner thighs drawing together, rotate a small circle on the ceiling and then switch directions. So creating this tiny little circle on the ceiling, hands can remain at your side. Exhale, rotate. Inhale. Exhale, rotate. Inhale at the top. Go at your own pace. And if you're feeling any sort of lower back pain, you can bend at the knees a little bit and still draw those circles, send that energy direction through the knees. One more in each direction. And pause. Bringing it back to tabletop. Let's come up to our ab prep. Bring the hands by the ears. We're gonna take it to a bicycle or obliques. Opposite elbow to opposite knee. Return back to tabletop. Lots of control here. Notice that we're not speeding through a bicycle pedal motion, but bringing the leg fully back to tabletop before you twist and rotate. Long lines. Exhale as you twist, inhale as you return. Rib cage draws towards the hip line. Neck line is not carrying any tension here. Feel that exhale twist. Nice. Three, two, and let's add a little extra burn here by taking those toes up to the ceiling. Reach towards the toes, come back down. Reach, belly button draws to the spine, spine to the mat. Five, four, shoulders draw away from the ears, neck is carrying no tension, and done. Draw the knees into the chest, release the lower back a little bit, you can rock side to side. All right, we're gonna bring it up to a seated position. You can do that by rolling up vertebrae by vertebrae or rolling onto your side and pushing off. We're gonna take it into a bit of a plank series. So I'm gonna have you flip it around. This can be modified for each individual body. So if you know that your wrists bother you, then come down onto your elbows. If you have some shoulder issues, make sure that you come down to your knees. If you need help on modifications, please reach out. Because it's not something I want you to get injured on. These can be pretty challenging. So bringing it down on the elbows is where I'm going to start. Keep those elbows stacked below the shoulders. We're gonna lift through the hips into dolphin and exhale to come back down to plank. Inhale, lift up to dolphin. Press through those heels. Feel that stretch at the top. Inhale, back down. Exhale, press. Inhale, return. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth. Keep those heels grounded, knees evenly spaced apart. Drive through the palm on each side. Come up to a child's pose. Press that belly button in towards the spine. Drive through the heels. Drive through the palms. Shimmy your left foot towards the middle of your mat. We're going to bring that right knee in towards your chest as you come to push-up position. And reach it back towards the back of the room. Belly button draws to the spine, push-up position. Reach as you come up to down dog. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, shoulder blades draw to the ears. Here, you can come down onto your elbows Feel that stretch through the spine and opening up the hips. If you need to relieve some tension, you can place a towel underneath your hip or a yoga block. And bring it up, let's switch to the other side. Tuck that knee in, press that thigh into the mat, set your hips up, and then lower it down to your forearms. Keeping the cervical spine in neutral. Alright, we're going to shift our weight onto the hips and set up for mermaids. So, bringing one foot up underneath the knee and the other foot reaching back towards the back of the room or your wall. One hand is going to be placed on the mat. So here's the first modification. You can just reach up and kind of lift onto that front leg and then slow control down, or you can come all the way up into a side plank. So ground your foot, be ready to ground your foot, be ready to ground your palm. Keep your chest open and facing forward. Taking the hands at your side, you're going to inhale. On your exhale, open up the side body, bring it up to your side plank and back down. Lengthen, reach the arms overhead, get that oppositional stretch. Inhale, exhale, reach, control down, and oppositional stretch. Shoulder blades draw away from the ears, feel those inner thighs squeeze as you bring that body up into your side plank. Exhale. If you need to modify protecting the wrists, you can place a bit of a Bosu ball or a box underneath your elbow when you come up, or do that other modification where I had you keep one knee down. Good. Let's switch it to the other side. Tucking one foot in, extending through the opposing heel, dropping that hand. Focus on keeping your palm slightly below your shoulder or right in line with the shoulder. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, press through the palm, come up. Keep your rib cage stacked in line with your hips and get that oppositional mermaid to the other side. Inhale, big reach up, up and over. Create that nice big C curve at the top. Exhale, reach. Inhale. Grounding the feet as you lift off. Get one more on this left side. And return. All right, let's work through the legs a little bit. So we're gonna bring it up into a kneeling side leg series. So we'll start on the right side, give this left side a break. So taking your palm down on the mat, ground your knee into the mat as you set your upper body up. Top hand can come up to your hip, roll that shoulder back, lift the top leg. We're gonna take it to a lift and lower, lift and lower. Keep your head in line with your spine. Make sure you're not reaching too far forward or too far back. Lengthen through the toe. And pause. Mini circles here. Keep the shoulder rolled back, keeping the chest open. Even breath and reverse. Mini circles from the hip. And get ready for two kicks forward, one kick back. Two kicks and lengthen back. Two kicks. Belly button draws to the spine. Feel the booty burn. Two and one. We'll flip it on over to the other side. So keeping the knee grounded, left palm is on the mat, hand is at your hip. We're gonna start with it right in line with the hip line. We're gonna take it to mini circles. Keeping your chest open, even breath, and reverse. If you need to extend your arm overhead, you can. Just make sure whatever you've done on this side is the same as what you did on the other side. Two kicks forward, one kick back. Feel feel that lengthen through the hip flexor. And lengthen. Two exhales and an inhale. Two, last one. Good, we're gonna bring it back to the center. Take it all the way down onto your side and we're gonna work the inner thighs and the obliques. So extending wall to wall on your mat, we're gonna bring that top leg up, bottom leg is gonna come up to match. So tap the heel, slow control down, very minimal weight in that hand that's on the floor. Shoulder blades are drawing back, rib cage is drawing in, belly button to the spine, keep your hips and shoulders stacked. Other hand can rest in front of you to help support the body. Feel the inner thighs. Two, last one. And then bringing both legs down, tuck that tailbone, hand on the top of the thigh or in front of the body. We're gonna lift the feet and the head and lower slow control down. Big reach, exhale. Inhale to lower. Energy through the crown of the head. Support the neck. Very minimal push through the hand. Last one. And let's bring it up and over to the other side. Working inner thighs and obliques. Keeping the hand extended on the bottom, unless you had it tucked under. So keep it the same on both sides. Hand rests in front of the stomach, helping support the torso. Top leg is extending, bottom leg comes up to match. Slow control down. Check your pelvis in. Make sure you have that tailbone tucked. Slight lift through those bottom obliques. You've got that support coming from the center to help lift through the legs. Inner thighs are on fire. Two, and one, and let's stack that top hand. Take an inhale on your exhale, lift, and lower. Very little support with that bottom hand. Inner thighs are squeezing. Lots of energy through the toes. Using those obliques through the side body to help control the motion. And done. Good. Let's push up, take it back into a child's pose. We'll take it to a few stretches and then we'll be done for today. So pressing back into the heels, lengthen through the spine. And tuck that tailbone. We'll bring it up to a seated position. We'll take it to butterfly to begin with. So bottoms of the feet together, hands at your ankles, roll those shoulders back. Opening up the hips. Allow the energy to just press through the knees. If you need to place your hands behind your back, you can. Rolling the shoulders back. Connecting with your breath, checking in your posture. Taking both feet to the front. We'll round through the back. Exhale as you round. Dropping the chin. Release through the hamstrings. And rolling up. We'll release the quads and hip flexors. So bringing it up to a kneeling position. We're going to keep one knee grounded and press through the hip flexor. So you're going to feel that open up to the front as you ground through the heel and press into that front leg. Straightening out the front leg will release the hamstring. You can reach towards your toe, both hands, or help your body by supporting the feet or the hands on the floor. And we'll switch sides. Keeping one knee grounded, press into that front leg. Neutralize the spine. Press through the hip flexor. bringing it back to the center. You can crisscross the legs or take it to butterfly. We're gonna release the neck and finish with two deep breaths. So hands can come to your side, dropping the ear to the shoulder. You can place one hand over the head to give a little bit of a tug, or you can give a little press through the shoulder, opposite shoulder. And up and over to the other side. Gently lowering the ear to the shoulder, pulling down on the opposite side. Feel that stretch as you lengthen through the neckline. And pulling through the center, we'll lower the chin to the sternum. Keep the shoulders drawing back. Thank you so much for joining me. If you like this workout, please be sure to like and subscribe and share this with any friends that you may have. Also be sure to reach out if you have any questions whatsoever or want to see something in future videos. All right.